Hi everyone, I'm Surabhi. I'm a homeschooling mother of two little girls aged 5 and 6. And in today's video, I'm going to share the games which we play. Especially nowadays, we are playing a lot of games because kids are home all the time. So I thought I'll share what games work with my 5-year-old who doesn't know much reading or doesn't have much attention span. But you know, she can sit and play with me for some time. She knows numbers 0 to 9 and like they know it well, and colors and shapes, that's all. So she's not like... cannot read the questions, cannot think so much cognitively, something like that. So the very basic simple games which we have played with her, we still play with her nowadays especially. So let's start. So first one is a game which is called Spot It. So the point of Spot It is it helps in focus building, it helps in vocabulary. There are these set of cards, and if you can play it multiplayer, any or two also can play. So if me and my daughter are playing, my elder one is not playing, so I'll snap these two cards in front of her like this. And she has to find one thing which is common between both of them. So you know, she needs a lot of focus. So my 5-year-old doesn't have much attention span, she can't sit for much time, she's a kinesthetic learner. So this game really helped her focus. So because she has to sit and really focus which two pictures are same. So like in this one, we have Caesar's common. Okay, so if she tells Caesar common, identify which is same, then she earns one card. Then I show another card. Find what is common in these two. And as soon as if we are playing, three of us are playing, my another daughter is also playing, then their competition I put on the floor, and the one who identifies, they spot it. And then ask, what did you spot? And she'll say, okay, I spot a hand. Okay, you earn the card. So it can be played competitive way, or it can be only played only with the focus of attention building. Because I play with her only for attention building, and then these used to play, or I play with them for... no competition, and just as a game like that. So second game, which again for memory building, for my younger one mainly, she can't remember much things, but this game really helps her just like keep remembering things. So these things help indirectly in academic stuff also, and these are the stuff which really work with kids because they're fun. They are not like you have to remember the chapter, you have to remember 10 plus 5, remember the tables, not like that. These are fun games which they play, and eventually the brain starts working in that direction. So this is a memory game. So it's like matching game, okay? So these are the cards. It's from Frank Games. It's an Amazon. So like there are two cards of each, okay? And then they'll be put down like this on the floor like this. And then you have to open each card and find the matching cards. The one who finds the matching card wins those cards. So like I have a big bunch of cards. I'll be putting them on the floor like upside down like this. And... then if she picks up like these two, like we used to play dolls. Oh, these two match? No, they don't match. Put them down. So she has, again, a competitive way. If we three are playing, we take turns. We learn making turns. But if me and her are playing, then again, I'll remember. She'll not remember. It still is working. And now she is so good at this game. Even I can't remember that much. But she remember the positions and everything. And this way we play memory games. So you can, use any game. Any game which has, similar cards. There are some vocabulary cards you get. Anything. Or you can buy cards of, two sets of cards. That also I have done, that you get fish cards. So I got two sets of them and used them as a memory game, So anything, but just like put all the cards on the floor, which minimum two are matching, and then find the matching cards and remember where the position was. This is a memory game which you play with her. This is our old Uno. So, she knows 0 to 9 for short, but more than 10 she has. So if you play with the normal cards, she gets frustrated in between because it's too much to remember for her. So this is very easy. You distribute 3 cards each to members, and either you have to match the number or you have to match the color. So if I have put 6 yellow down, she should have a yellow or a 6 number, and if she find it, she put it down. Otherwise, then the one who finished the cards will be the winner. So this is pretty simple and self-explanatory game, but again, it helps her to focus and sit in one place for some time. We are revising our numbers, we are revising our colors, and it takes minimum energy from my end. It's easy for me to play with her. I don't explain many rules, and she gets to win many times, so that keeps her going and playing this game. Next one is this the Go Birds card. So you can play with your normal cards which we have. We don't have those cards, but this is again, it has a similar like that, but it has some pictures also. Okay, so we played by two ways. So you can use the same way to play other playing cards, which are the adult playing cards. You can do the same thing with that. I have a small version. These cards are smaller, so it can be held easily with the hand of kids. And they're pretty, they were pretty cheap, so that's what we have still not given them the big play cards. So what you do is you distribute. Make two bunch of cards, you know, like this bunch I'll take, this one she'll take. Okay, now you both of us do not see the card. In India we played satte pe satta. Like if you find the matching card, you say satta and then you get that card. So like if this is my card, this is mine, this is hers. Okay, we will put in the card on like this and this. If so, now because she don't understand KJ, you can play in two ways. One is what is the shape here, and one is a number. So as of now we are just playing with the shapes because the numbers are pretty small and she gets confused, but you can play both ways. So if I put this and she puts this, so our shape is matching and she says quack, and if I see the number, then she earns those cards. Same way you can play with numbers. So if it's a J, and if by chance I had a J, even the shapes are different, then she will say quack and you won the card. So the end who has all the cards is the winner. So here again we are focusing on attention span. It's very small, so you have to observe the one card put below is heart or a leaf or a diamond. So that way we play these cards. Or again, focusing on numbers if you have the matching cards. So again, this all helps in, you know, retaining, focusing, sitting in one place and be focused and, you know, sharp to squack and earn the card. Now next we are to board games. This is sequence for kids. So there's adult sequence, I have not seen that, but this is especially for kids. It's a pretty simple game and they're only animal shapes, so there's no numbers, alphabets involved. So these, when my younger one did not know numbers and used to get frustrated with alphabets and numbers on the cards and these kind of games, when she didn't even know 0 to 9 much, she used to play this game. So this my 6-year still loves to play it, so it's a fun game, so you like it. So this is, you get a board. So when you put it on the floor, it all is joined. So you have different animals on it. And then along with that, you have cards, which are animal cards. The cards, and then you get the chips. These are like the scoring things, you can say. And yes, like these. So one, like if me and my daughter is playing, usually we three play together because my elder one loves it. So like if one gets all the yellow chips, there are many, like a big bunch of chips for each. So one gets all the red, one get blue, one get green, like that. Now we distribute seven cards, three cards or four cards, whatever. So this also is depending on the holding capacity of my child. So when she was very small, we used to give only three cards. And now she wants more. And so usually three is okay. By rule, you can change rules, but yeah, you get three cards. So if I have got three cards, everyone has three cards, okay, in the team, and then one is a discard pile. And so I got these ones. So if I put my lion down on the board, wherever is my lion, I'll put my chip there. Like this chip will go to the lion. So I'll pick up the card. Every time you throw a card, always you have three cards. So the one who can make a queue or a column of three chips in same line, like if I have blue color, if I can put three blue colors in one line, I win. I can block other people's putting cards. I'll throw my card and try to block someone else's line. You can do that. So, and you have all the animals, so there is nothing Hindi, English or maths involved, just pictures. And still it's a competitive game. And I also love this game when I started doing competitive games with my kids because they wanted to win all the time. And because we did not have much attention span, so this is a very small game, three cards to hold. So it was very amicable for my younger one who doesn't want to sit for a long time, who can't hold so many cards, who gets overwhelmed with a huge game and numbers and nothing, just pictures. Match the animal if you have that card and put the chip there, and if you can make three in a row, you win. It's a pretty simple and easily manageable game for my both 5 and 6 year old, and they're playing it since they were very small. Now this one, Hoot Owl Hoot, I cannot recommend it for anything more because this is still their favorite game for a main reason, that it's a cooperative game. it is not a competition. And when I was feeling a lot of sibling rivalry, a lot of competition between my girls is the only game I used to go to, because every other game there is some kind of competition. You are gaining some cards, you are gaining some points, you are gaining some chips. There was here, there is no competition. Here, both my daughters, and even if I am playing with them, we three will be in one team against the sun to make the owls win. So what this game is about, I'll show you the board. This is this one. So this is a game board. This is a nest. This is the sun. And they're color coded, so you don't need numbers or alphabets or any knowledge. Just you know the colors. That's the only thing required from a child. And then we have pieces in it. So again, you distribute three cards each. So this kind of cards. So there is specific thing is the sun card. They are color cards. And they are owls. So the game, so you'll be distributing all these cards among the players, three cards each, and the owls will be here. So if I my owl is sitting here, okay, if I throw a blue color card, my owl has to go to next blue color available. So my owl will reach here, and there is no competition. So we all are owl team, and our competition is with the sun. If we get a sun card, we have to throw it, and then there is a sun chip. We have like a owl chip, we have a sun chip, and the sun will start moving from here. Every sun card you throw, a sun will move one step ahead. And if it's morning time and the owl has not reached back to the nest, then we all lose. So basically you are competing against the sun in the favor of the owls. There's no personal interest involved, and this helped us a lot for you know, establishing peace in the house, for working as a team. And it teaches many basic concepts in the game, like there are not only one owl, you can play with one owl also, but like there are six owls you put, okay? So the owls have to go in, like if the blue card, they jump all over these cards. You teach so many things with it that, you know, you have to work as team. You have to remove all the six owls and bring them up. It's not that you have only one dice or like one manipulative and you just take one to home and you win. You have six owls. All six has to be taken care of. It's not that you have one and you keep putting blue, 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 blue and he reaches you win. No. All the six have to be brought home. Even if, you know, five owls reach home and one owl is left somewhere else, my goddaughters are very sad that, you know, mama, we could not save one owl. It teaches a lot of empathy and, you know, not think of competition and thinking of themselves as a team. I cannot recommend this game well anymore. I mean, like, just buy it if you get it anyway. It's a very pretty costly game. I got, someone was selling, so in the second hand I got, but, one of our favorite games. So these are the games just keeping us busy, and hope you enjoy it, and bye if you get a chance to buy them. Thank you. Bye bye.